continuing on this figure. I've got a backpack to add today, and that will tell me how much detail I need in the back. And I've decided to put her arm up to sort of like she's got her thumb under the strap that's coming down over her shoulder. This hand here will be holding a camera, and got to figure out how I'm going to do that. And I think I'm going to have a walking stick hanging from her wrist, but I haven't decided what to do on that either. So all these things will happen as I do them. And just looking to see what kind of dowels I have so I can decide whether I'm going to do a walking stick or not. Well, I got some good dowels over there. Okay. So, and I guess the next thing is just get started. Well, I've got a prior engagement tonight, so I'm not going to be able to work very much long, but I'm going to at least get as far as I can in the next hour. This backpack is going to take a huge amount of clay. Let's make a foam thing and then cut it down to size. That way I don't use all my clay. I think I'll do that. Foam part on the paper here. I'm going to tape it down to this cutting board. Wax paper will allow me to take the foam off of the wax paper. I'm going to take a measurement using my calipers of her back. Now it will cover about that area right there. Not quite the full back. It'll probably be narrower at the top like a typical backpack, but I don't see that in that backpack I'm looking at. So I'm just gonna sketch out the parameters of the backpack. That's the width, and I'm gonna want it to go down to about right there. So it is really windy outside and cold today, so you're going to hear a lot of wind noise today in the background, I think. All right, now I'm going to go a little bit bigger so I can carve off what I don't need. And then I'm going to take this tape and make a small reservoir for the foam. I hope this works to keep the foam from coming out from underneath. It's not going to take a lot of foam. There we go. As I've said before, doing foam is not a thing for minors. It's a very dangerous thing because this stuff gets on you And there ain't getting it off. Now this is the B compound of the mixture. I'm not going to do too much. I think I'm going to just do about that much. Paper towel. Always pays to clean the top of the bottle with a paper towel so you don't have a buildup of material. Do the same amount in that cup. This stuff isn't really all that expensive for what you get out of it. I used it when I did a life-size monument, and it took a lot of space. That would have been taking up my clay. All right. Get all my tools together. It turns creamy color when it gets mixed. I'm not going to use all this, but it's better to have too much than not enough. I'm not going to wait that long. I think that's all I need. Oh, it's starting to get hot now. I better go throw this stuff away. Boy, it sure didn't take long much, did it? Thank goodness I put that that wax paper down. Boy, you find out how dull your knife is. Ooh, that's hot. It's like plaster. When plaster sets up, it gets really hot. Well, this gets really hot, too. I think I might take this outside and carve it away so I don't get foam all over everything. Because as you can see, it gets right in there, and I don't want to get it in the clay over here. Last thing you want to get in your sculpture is foam. I'm going to go put my coat on and go outside and do a little carving. I'm not going to video it, but I'll be back. I've been asked several times over the years, what happens to this armature when it's they make a mold of it and then they cast it in bronze? Well, the mold will only come up about right there, and it'll only get about maybe a half an inch to an inch of this post. And what they'll do is in the wax stage, they'll just cut that post off, so it has no effect. Now, I am attaching this to the figure, and screw the backpack on her back. There we go. That'll just keep it in place. Put some clay on. I got a little time left. I thought I was running out of time, but I got time to at least start the clay. There we go. Got the clay started. I'll put detail work into it, and I'll cut away where I need to cut away. But well, I got my coat on. I'm ready to go. And I'll see you guys next week. I have the weekend pretty well filled with other things I'm going to be doing and I committed to. If I can get any time this week, tomorrow, I'll try to work on it, but I kind of doubt it. But it's getting there. It's at the stage right now where I just want to tear it apart and start over again. But I go through that with every piece I ever do, and you just sort of have to just sit back, relax. It's going to take a couple of days away from it, and that's good because then I can come back and look at it and see what I need to change. But right now I like what's happening. And just have to keep playing with it. Yeah. Just changed her body position just a little bit. Because that was bothering me a little bit. Because she was too stiff. And I wanted to put a little more flow into her body. I'm going to have a camera, like I said before, in this hand, her thumb under the strap for the backpack here. I think it's going to turn out pretty good. I'll finish it up next week and move on to another project. All right, everybody, have a great weekend. I hope I do. And I'll see you guys next week. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.